Okay, good morning, Grade 2.
Good morning, Miss Mockery.
My name's Megan, and I have a Grade 2 class here at Cairns West in North Queensland. Alex.
Yeah.
We have a large population of Indigenous and Torres Strait Islander kids.
Beautiful city.
We've got Hmong and African.
She's not here.
There's a lot of socioeconomic disadvantage.
Who can tell me what text type we've been learning about? Sadella?
Narratives.
We have this guarantee for our parents at the school if they sign up to what's called the Academic Success Guarantee.
Made up a real story.
They're signing up to say that they're going to send their child to school every day, and then we guarantee that they're going to meet eventually the benchmark level for where they should be at that age level.
Where is the story set, Athalia?
Setting.
I'm going to teach an English lesson today, and it's breaking down parts of the narrative structure within the story.
Characters.
Good. And where the story is set, we're talking about the
setting.
Setting. Excellent.
In order to do this task, they need to develop their oral literacy, language skills.
We've been learning things about the characters in the book. What have we been learning about the characters?
Leaving work for Mrs. Piggott to do.
Yeah, they always leave the work for poor old Mrs. Piggott. So
at the start of the lesson, I try and relate it to a real-life situation. So I just sort of say, oh, do you know someone in your life that's a little bit like this character?
Helpful.
She is helpful. What name do we give to
We set high expectations.
What are they called?
Adjectives.
Good boy.
So I scaffold their learning.
We know.
So when they've met what their learning object was, then I take it to a little bit of a higher level so they reach that with success. They feel like they're learning. They feel like they're succeeding. So I give them the structure to work with first, and then from that we do lots of game-based activities that are fun for them to do.
What does that say,
Liam? To clean and wash.
So the word is?
Wash.
Wash, and its meaning is?
To clean.
To clean. Good boy. So you've got the first matching pair. Well done. You can hold on to that now.
If we can see that they're struggling, if they're not reaching that level, then we break it down further.
Evening. What does evening mean?
Well, I usually say, oh, well done for having a go. And then I go to a different student and say, and what do you think?
Who can help Milani?
And sort of join it together.
Nice time.
Give them feedback
so that
way.
Can find a picture. Find the matching pair.
As long as they're having a go, then we catch
so
that.
So close. Well done.
Yeah, give them learning success. Turn. I do lots of hands-on activities.
What do we see at night time?
Using the kids' bodies to
so evening.
Act out parts of the story so that they can understand the language that's used in the text.
We can walk along our arm for the tracking word. The, that's a tracking word, good. Boys. Yes, you can point to a boy, good.
The hand signs also help out with plurals, learning tense.
Got. How can we show? I like yours, Racy. You're getting something. You're grabbing something. You've got it. Okay,
so that they can eventually get to that high level that we expect them to achieve. So Cairns West holds a lot of community events. I am given the chance to talk to the parents, just sort of hear their family stories, where they've come from, and I use that knowledge to then create learning experiences for my kids. Find out what they enjoy doing. If they are more of a hands-on learner, then I'd provide more hands-on learning activities for that particular child. I wanted to walk around the school and identify the sources of water that we use in the school because we have begun talking about Earth's resources.
Okay, boys and girls, next we're going to go to the community garden over near the library.
It's an authentic learning experience. It's somewhere they come every day. And sometimes for some of the kids at our school, the school's only their only sort of stable environment.
So they can grow.
So it's important that I step up to that supportive role and encourage them to do the best that they can.